Welcome back. As we continue in Railway Empire 2, enjoying the view of our exclusive skin for both our train station and our headquarters building. We also have exclusive skins for the John Bull and another locomotive. This is the exclusive skin for the John Bull that you get with the deluxe edition of Railway Empire 2. It's very beautiful. But we've already established that the John Bull is sus. So I'm good. The other one, is actually, I'll just show you on the screen. But I like my livery better. Feel the rhythm. Feel the rhyme. It's bobsled time. On our way to Washington, D.C. Actually, we are at Washington, D.C. We're on our way to Philadelphia with a small load. 44 passengers. 44 pieces of mail. Wow. The locomotive whale. So yeah, as you can see, our cities are doing pretty well. We got two cities going at double the rate, and we're low on cash right now, so we probably just have to do some housekeeping for the next few moments. Let's do some housekeeping in regards to our tasks. We're ahead in terms of these, but we're in big trouble still. Get this done in 7 years. Use 128 trains at the same time. I get nightmares about this. We're on our way to Quebec to get this one done. This one is a sleeper. We're at 4 cities, so we should be okay here. And connect 2 rural businesses producing grain to your rail network by 1832 December. So we have a good amount of time, because it's really just a matter of deciding which direction we want to go. I noticed that grain is really hard to come by the further north you go, which I guess geographically it makes sense. And definitely you can't find corn up here. So the closest grain is all the way in Moncton, Maine, which is probably Nova Scotia, to be honest. Well, anywho, let's review our trains in terms of their capacity. So we got a bunch of fully loaded trains. Medium load, sort of yellow. And then we have some relatively empty ones. Those are express trains. I don't mind the express trains being express and lightweight, you know? I think we're working pretty good. We're making 20,000 a week. Usually that would have given us an achievement. But for some reason, this role has been very trapping, to say the least. This is interesting. They actually moved. If you remember from a previous episode, they were closer to here. I've seen them move, but I never seen them move just a few clicks. This is really interesting. I think they move wherever the buffalo go. And then there's another group here. Given the location, I'm guessing that they're Cherokee. In 1832, there was the Black Hawk War. And as you can see, the teepees change in design. Let's see if they all are different, or is it just the two different designs? It's only two. And then you'll notice that it says wool farm, but then when you go close to the wool, you see that it's cotton. And the reason for that is they just didn't want to say a cotton farm, because then if they were to be historically accurate, they would have a bunch of slaves here. So, just to avoid a certain can of worms, they didn't bother to call this cotton, and they just called it wool. And I'm guessing the way it's designed like this, it means that they used to have it as cotton, and then like, almost like before they released the game, they had a review and somebody was like, I don't know if you want to go there. And then some German guy was like, ah, yes, it's true. We don't want to open that kind of worms. Yeah, so let's see what our finances are looking like. Our expenses, we're pretty much always at a profit so far, so that's good. And we have no debts. Our valuation is at 4 million. And the quantum risks charter. It's doing pretty good. Now, as you remember, the engineer, Idris Bailey, was designed based off a real person whose name was Isambard Kingdom Brunel. He died of a stroke at the age of 53. While Brunel was very successful throughout his life, he struggled a great deal with criticism and illness. His above average consumption of cigars may have contributed to the latter. Sources say that he smoked up to 40 cigars a day. You know, when you're being sarcastic, you know, it's not easy being cheesy. Sometimes you don't know what people are going through. Especially when they feel like they have the weight of the world on their shoulders. And you could use that as evidence that he was probably somewhat isolated. Nobody there to tell him to calm down, you know? So we can get a bonus if we connect. Ooh, we got an empty train. This one is from Martin Terminal, which is here, to Philly. It's not supposed to pick up anything. This one is orange, so it will resolve itself. Realigning complete. Sure. Been waiting to be loaded for 4 weeks. Wilson rest. Oh, it's not supposed to pick up anything. The game is kind of clunky when it comes to that type of coding. It's like it has a bunch of if-else statements, and it's like if the destination doesn't need anything, stay there and wait until it needs something. So you really have to be minding your train line. Are you guys out low on production? It's kind of unfair to expect the one farm to supply the entire tri-state area, you know? Which might be a good time to connect this one next to Buffalo, because it has corn there too. And we've accumulated some additional income since the commencement of this episode. I would say it's better to just play the game at your own pace and not, other than like completing your tasks, not be overly obsessive on trying to connect every city as fast as possible, because each city is like a grown man child. we do have the bread to entertain bridges. But in real life, maintaining bridges are a nightmare. So we'll just try to avoid any type of bridging. This 4% grade is probably gonna be too harsh on the John Bull. There you go. I think that will work. Unacceptable. I think that works. What do you think? Probably remove this one. This one right here. Can I get this to 2%? Wow. Can I get this to 2%? Can I get this to 2%? Do I have a bridge now? No bridge. A very small bridge here. 4%. That's better.
Hey! You have completed this task.
I'm too broke at this point to get a second line. Those are for rich folk. So in case you're wondering, I'm hoping to connect Albany directly to Syracuse without going through the the freight line. Alright, so since you're empty, let's just add Jackson Station and let's go to Moore Terminal instead. $2,000 a week. As far as it can go for now. While we're poor peasants. At least now we have two lines. Send this gridiron as far as it can go again. Let's see what upgrades we could do next. Six cities. Let's try to get Syracuse. No, we don't need Syracuse. Let's try to get Boston connected by the end of this episode. So the secret to corn is buying the farms, but as you know, that's going to be at least $500,000, and buying them is not enough. You have to buy them and then upgrade them to meet the needs of your empire. We get more comfortable, get some more money out of each train. So seat upholstery increases the number of passengers in all cities with one of your train stations by 5%. And you want a personal office, reduces cost charged by personal office for well-being of your employees by 5%. Increases the ticket price if you get train whistles, so let's get some train whistles going. Speedometer, if increase the efficiency of your driving operation. Yeah, let's do this. A simple seat upholstery makes traveling much more comfortable. They make the most money, so the customer always... Wow, instead of the customer, can we? Let's help the customer first. Do we help the customer increases the maximum speed of your locomotives? Yeah. What do you want to be? Comfortably slow or quick? Get it over with. Oh, nice. We make $40,000 a week now. Probably gonna go ahead and drop me a station as soon as I got to 50. I'll drop me a station in Boston. I want my express line, like, to be honest with you, skip this train station altogether. I'll just turn here into a warehouse. I could bring the goods from here and here to here, then disperse them across here, or here, right here. Now we wait for when we can afford actual real land. I mean, we could just take a loan, but what's the point in that? As you could see the path that they already take. The old country road. I can only assume that it's like level. In a kind of a hole out here. So this one will probably be, it will probably end up being two lines that go straight to the fruit farm, two lines that go straight to the cattle, and two lines, or four, that goes straight to Boston. But as you know, for the beginning phase, we just do what we can. Look how expensive this is. This is because our station is facing down. We have to be lifting it out. Ready of a rebuild. I'm gonna take it across this level ground here. And if you remember the tip I gave you before, you wanna rebuild a portion of a line without deleting the whole thing. You just add a supply tower. B for build. Recoup some money by deleting the supply tower. Another thing is, when you delete trains, you get money back, but you don't get the actual money that you've invested in the first place. So keep that in mind. I don't like this at all, so I'm inevitably gonna delete this line. I don't understand why it went snorkeling. kind of ugly. And this is kind of what I meant too when I mentioned the distance the crow flies. Because the distance the crow would fly would be directly to here. So the amount of distance I'm allowed to use in between there is only up to twice this amount, which I guess I'm okay because I'm probably maybe 110% instead of over 200%, or yeah, over 200%. But if this was a mile, I'm at like a mile and 10. 1.1 mile, 1.2 miles, and not over 2 miles, so I'm okay. Now we wait for a second line, and until then, set up another train. Keep it at automatic for now. Can't afford that yet either. Go figure. And we wait patiently for the funds to connect a second reel. Until then, let's explore a little bit, shall we? Boston. Before they had cars. Meat and passengers. This train's too weak for all this. Just a little bit more work on the graphics. Pretty sure they're gonna do the updates eventually. I believe this is the Appalachian Trail, Appalachian Mountain. it takes months to hike down all these. It goes all the way down. I think it goes through North Carolina, South Carolina. Eventually you have a portion called the Smoky Mountains. That's where you find more of the Cherokee. Simba, whatever the light touches is part of our kingdom. We need to shoot some hogs, eating up all our stock. Cost of doing business. Should be sugar cane. Doesn't look like sugar cane though. Now there are two groups in the same area. So awesome. Alright, I think we have enough money to go back up north and get that second rail. Get the personal well-being up the bar. And this is where we'll end the episode. After connecting this line. exclusive skins. We're gonna need 2 supply towers next episode. Cause that's a long trick. And we need a maintenance depot. Either at the hub stop or at Boston. I think we should put it at the hub stop. Since it's gonna become relatively central and essential. Picking up fruit, passing resources. So did we, but hey, who's counting? On our way to Boston, we just do the customary ride along. And I'll catch you in the next episode. We'll be right back.